Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. First of all, thank you very much, Brother Naveed and your team, for arranging such an important event. And then I also thank the respectable panelists on both sides. And then, of course, the respectable attendees who have come here in this cold weather to join and listen to us and participate in this important event. And after that, I must remember the three young Muslims who were murdered in North Carolina. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our God, that they rest in peace. And then I also remember Kayla Muller from the Arizona, the aid worker who lost her life. And there are many others belonging to all kinds of faiths, not just Muslims, who have lost their lives or they have become injured, seriously injured, significantly injured, and have become handicapped and facing very rough and tough times at the hands of these terrorists who are doing all of these acts by falsely calling them Muslims, and they are doing it falsely in the name of Islam. I unconditionally condemn that, and I'm sure that all of us condemn that. But then at the same time, the reality is that they are doing it in the name of Islam. So of course there is increasing hate against Islam, and there is increasing hate against Muslims. And the incident in North Carolina was an evidence to that, that this is a reality which we are facing and we gotta do something about it. I see that I'm very quickly getting to the red, and I usually do that. So let me try to quickly wrap up. I have 3 points. We gotta do something about this. And what can we do about it? This Islamophobia and the increasing hate against Islam and Muslims. We got to create the opportunities for having all different kind of people, all different kind of faith people, to get together in friendly environments so that we can interact with each other, we can understand each other better, so that this impression that Muslims are terrorists or Islam calls for terrorism, it can be seen firsthand when the people interact with Muslims that all of that is false. It is a religion of pure peace, and all of the Muslims are just the common people like any other faith people, and there is no reason to believe that, you know, they will be mischievous or planning bad acts like, you know, whatever these few people are doing in the name of Islam or Muslims. So we at Islamic Society of Delaware, we have the masjid on Salem Church Road. We had a gathering, well attended gathering a couple of weeks ago. And similarly, this Saturday at 6 p.m., we are having another event. And it is an interfaith event, basically. And we want to encourage people to come and sit with us, you know, mingle with us, and have the opportunity to understand each other better. So I actually invite all of you, the panelists, as well as all of the attendees, to come and join us for that event this Saturday at 6 p.m. That's one thing, and we have to continue creating these opportunities to get together. I'm already on that, but quickly, just two more points. The second thing is that our security, the government officials are doing their job. I know Jeff, I know Charles overly. Similarly, we had very good meeting with Newcastle County, County Executive. They are also taking a proactive approach in developing a program to enhance security and safety for Muslims and their facilities. But then our organization also have to do our part. So each of us have to think about, and of course, you know, the responsibility is directly on the shoulders of the leaders like me, or the leaders of the other organizations, that we also have to develop the programs at each organization level to somehow develop security programs for us, that how we can protect ourselves better with everybody's help, the government official as well as all of the community against us. And the last point is that we got to also understand that these guys, the terrorists we call them, who are doing all of this in the name of Islam or calling themselves Muslims or whatever, but they are somehow able to get sympathy and support from people in different corners of the world, unfortunately. So there are underlying causes, and those underlying causes are making it possible for them to actually gain the sympathy and support, and that's why they are able to just continue doing all of this. So I urge all of us to also think about that and see whatever we can do to convey messages to our government officials, our politicians, our leaders, to understand the underlying causes and do whatever we can do to control them, so that we can choke the sympathy and support for these terrorists. So with that, I'm sorry, I apologize that I took a few minutes probably more, but I knew that I'm going to run very quickly to the right. But thank you very much for allowing that, Brother Naveed, and everybody else. Thank you very much.